James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Grant us to sit, one at your right hand, one at your left, in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the ten heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called to them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. Whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated.
After reading this, two questions came to my mind. The first question was, how can I relate to what it means for me to serve others? The answer is simple: to be there even when there is no reward. To show the characteristics of Christ and to spread the word about him. My faith reminds me of how important it is. Because Jesus Christ himself came here to serve. Not to be served. Serving isn't about us receiving attention or glory. It is for God to receive glory. And how does God receive his glory when we serve? God's power to transform us is on display whenever we help others. How else can our life be transformed by serving? When you serve, you become a minister of God. You spread the word. You show how Christ works. Whenever I serve, I love watching the reaction of people. Seeing them happy makes me happy. Knowing that I'm here to help someone, to show how great Christ is, and being that minister, that makes me glad. Although there are many times when I serve, I don't get to see the outcome of what I've done. But I know in my heart that I've made a positive difference in someone's life in Jesus' name. I don't serve because I'm told to do so. I serve because I want to show people that even through the toughest times, Christ is with me. Christ is with you. Christ is with us. I want to show people, especially the non-Christians, how Christ works. I want to spread the word. I want to do the best I can as a minister of Christ. Every time I serve, I know that God is with me, watching me. God is with us, watching us. I am with Jesus. We are with Jesus, serving right now in this church. Jesus enters our world the way we enter people's lives, to help them with whatever mess they're going through. And he is with us, making a difference. And he cleans that mess up. He cleans people up, showing that we are saved. Jesus is always there for us, serving us in our highest need. It is he who shows people the difference between selfishness and selflessness. We are not saved by service, we are saved to service. Jesus tells the disciples that in order to be a leader, you must be a servant to all. And in order to be first, you must be last and a slave to all. It is Jesus who is always there for us, understanding us, helping us, serving us. Pastor Chuck gave me this poem that I thought was very appropriate for serving. Is that you, Lord, changing the diaper in the nursing home, holding the spoon for the woman in her wheelchair, wiping down the toilet and the floor? Is that you? Serving the dinner at the homeless shelter, sorting the cans at the food bank, mowing the Asian neighbor's lawn. Is that you, Lord, bandaging the wounds of the bomb victim, erecting the tent for the refugees, handing out the water and the food? Is that you? Driving the patient to the treatment center, sitting through the night with the family, making the call to the forgotten friend. Is that you, Lord, lighting the candle in darkness, keeping vigil for compassion and justice, loving in us, and through us, and with us, until the world that you love has been changed? Is that you, Lord?
Amen.